Hi students, let's continue with the web attacks and their preventions. So in the previous video I explained about the one of the web attack, that is a cross-site scripting attack, and that prevention, and the distributed denial of service and the prevention. Now in this video I want to explain you about the SQL injection. So this is one type of the web attack, and let's see what is this SQL injection and what is the prevention of this SQL injection. So here injection means, you know, that we are that the attacker is trying to insert something so that he can damage the database. SQL means, whenever you have seen the word SQL, means it is relating to the database. So injection means the attacker is trying to entered some code, he is trying to insert injection, that is entering some code into the web server so that the data can be manipulated. Okay, so here the attackers gains to access the database. Attacks, SQL injection attacks to gain access to database and steal. What it is doing? It steal the valuable information. Steal the valuable information from database. And even also destroying or alter. And destroying or alter data in database. So this is what this SQL injection will do. So the SQL injection attacks to gain access to the database, and it is going to steal the valuable information from the database, and it even also destroy or alter the data in the database. So the SQL injection actually occurs how? Let me explain. SQL injection occurs when malicious SQL statements, means the unwanted statements, okay, which is having some malicious code, malicious SQL statement, or inserted into form fields. So when you are entering the data on the database, where you are going to enter? Usually we are entering the in the client side, we are entering the data on the form table. Okay, just like a form table, in the form table you are entering the data. So while you are entering the data, so the SQL injection occurs when the malicious SQL statements are inserted into the form fields. So in this form field, some malicious SQL statements is also inserting into this field along with the user field. Okay, form fields. So here, which are not properly protected in code, okay, to try and gather the information from database. So with SQL injection, so what a hacker will do with this SQL injection? So with SQL injection, a hacker can change the price of a product. He can change the price of the product and gain the customer information okay. So this is what the SQL injection will do. So whenever we are the hacker is trying to inject the some malicious code, that is what we call it SQL injection. The hacker can change the price of the product, whatever it is there in the database. Means this is one of the example. Hacker can change the price of a product and he can gain the customer information also. Let me explain you with a simple example. SQL injection. So let's take, this is the user form. User is there. So user is entering that he want to access his database. So how you are going to access his database? By using the username and the password. So okay, username and the password. Okay, so he is entering with the password. Some conditions will be there, like capital letters, small letters has to be included. So the hacker can identify these things. Okay, this site is protected with some, like the password should be like this, like the, it includes the capital letters, small letters, like that it should, he is identifying. So the user, by entering the username and the password, whenever he click on the submit, he is going to access the web server. Okay, he is going to access the web server. Now the attacker, the attacker, what he is doing? The attacker is doing the SQL injection. So whatever the statement he is there, it is in the password. Okay. So a malicious code is injected. A malicious code will be injected and he is trying to access the web server. So whenever he entered the malicious code, it is matching with this username and the password and he is trying to access the web server. So whenever he accesses the web server, okay, the web server checks for correct password. The web server can't identify who is that person, means he is a correct person or not. He doesn't bother about it. It's just SQL is injection along with this field. So he can't identify an attacker is also entering into the web server. So simply whatever the users are there, he checks for the correct password and enter into the SQL server. That is a database. SQL server assesses the true condition. So whatever he want to access, that will be displayed. So that is displayed to whom? Now the attackers gets logged into the SQL server using SQL injection. Using SQL injection. Now the attacker can easily, with the help of this SQL injection, he entered into the SQL server. Whenever he entered into the SQL server, he can access the database, he can manipulate the database, he can modify that, he can change the details, he can gain complete information of the customer. Okay, so this is what the SQL injection attack was. So here the user as well as the attacker is both are going to access the web server. So how the attacker is going to access? With the help of this information, okay, the SQL, he is entering some code in this password. Along with this, he entering into the web server. Now, what is the prevention? So this is happening, this leads to some severe damage to the server as well as to the user information. Then how we are going to prevent this? The prevention for the SQL server is, the only thing is, in order to keep your database secure, you should practice regular auditing remediation, okay, of your application to ensure that any vulnerability is discovered. Okay, so we have to keep monitoring the database, auditing your database and rechecking your database every time you keep monitoring the database. And next, you have to use some tools and software to prevent this SQL injection. So what type of the tools and softwares I need to be used? Okay, you have to use the tools or software to keep an eye on your system security. So the examples for this is, like, you can use the security event manager. So who is going to always keep an eye on your system security? Security event manager, or you can use the NetSparker, vulnerability scanner. Okay, so these are all some prevention techniques for the SQL injection attack. Thank you.